Hello everybody. Last class we had discussed about the steady state error. So now we will continue with the problems of this. Hello everybody. Last class we had started with the we had explained the steady state error and the steady state error coefficient. What is steady state error? It is the difference between the desired and the actual output. The desired and the actual output will not be same usually, and the difference in that it is called at t equal to infinity, at some steady state or steady time, the difference in the two, the actual, the desired and the actual values will be the error. The difference is called the steady state error. And you have certain coefficient which will try to reduce or eliminate this steady state errors, and they are called the steady state, or that they are called the static error coefficient. We have dynamic error coefficient and static error coefficient. Here we are only studying about the static error coefficient. Static error coefficient, it is the ability of the system to reduce or eliminate the steady state error. They are certain coefficient values. Now we have already seen in the video the derivation. We have three steady state error coefficient, static error coefficient, that is the positional error coefficient, velocity error coefficient, and acceleration error coefficient. So there are three coefficients that we have studied, and we have also seen the derivation of that, how it is got, that is how the positional error is got. While deriving, we saw that the steady state error, static error, that is the positional static error coefficient, is nothing but limit s equal to infinity g of s into h of s, where h of s will be the feedback gain, and due to this the steady state error, this will be a by 1 plus kp. So by having this, if you have this value, the steady state error will reduce. By having a kp, this kp value is high, the steady state error will reduce. Similarly, the next one will be the velocity error coefficient. That is nothing but limit s tends to 0, s g of s into h of s. And the steady state error due to this is a by kv. And acceleration error coefficient, that is the static error coefficient, acceleration static error coefficient, it is limit s tends to 0, s square h of s into g of s into h of s. And the steady state error due to it is nothing but a by ka. And later on we also went to define the type and rank of the system. We had defined type of the system as number of zeros that will be, number of poles that will be present at the zero, at the origin. See, number of poles that will be present at the origin defines the type of the system. So based on that, we saw there were three types, type 0, type 1 and type 2. In type 0, we will have a positional error coefficient, and due to this, we will have the error due to step input. For different inputs, we had seen the error, how it is going to, how the errors are going to be, whether the error will be minimum, whether the error will be infinite. So all this was already discussed. So for type 0, we will always have positional error coefficient, whereas the other two will be 0. And for this positional error, when we give a step, that is for type 0, when we give a step input, it will have an error due to this positional error coefficient, and that value will be a by 1 plus k. A is the magnitude of the input, and here k, this value is will be substituted here in the place of kp. For these two, because it is 1 by kv and 1 by ka, so 1 by 0, 1 by 0 would give you infinity. For type 1 system, the positional error coefficient is infinity, whereas the velocity error coefficient is k and the acceleration will be 0. Similarly, for a type 1, if you give a step input, the error will be 0, will not have an error. If you try to the output and input will try to match, the desired and the actual values will try to match. whereas when you give a ramp input, there will be an error difference. So that is nothing but A by K. This value of K has to be substituted in the denominator. For a parabolic, the error will be infinite, means there will be a large difference. For type 2, these two errors are infinite. We will have acceleration error coefficient. And because these two are infinite, when you give a step and ramp input, the error will be 0. Whereas when you give a parabolic input, the error will be A by K. So with this basic, we will go into the problems now. The first problem here, a unit T feedback system has G of S equal to 40 into S plus 2 divided by S into S plus 1 into S plus 4. You have to determine the type of system, all error coefficient and error for ramp input with magnitude 4. So the first thing is they have asked us to find the type of system. That is, this is G of S. We know this is the general block diagram that we have. G of S is the this will be the gain, open loop gain. This is the feedback gain. So the entire transfer function is G of S into 1 plus H of S. This is minus negative feedback. So it is plus here. And due to this, we will have this is the expression. And here, G of S into H of S is nothing but H of S is 1, so it is 40 into S plus 2 divided by S into S plus 1 into S plus 4. So let us take out 2 outside here, keeping this 1, this 1 plus S. This is 2 outside, it is 1 plus 0.5S. Here take out 4. In this, we will have to take out 4. Let us take out 4 in this. So 4 into S, it is 1 plus S, 1 plus, when you are taking out 4, 1 by 4 will be 0.25. See here, it is not clear here. Here it is 0.25. So 4 and 4, it cancels. This is 10. 10 into 2 is 20. And the remaining values. If you look at this denominator, you have one pole at the origin, so it is type 1 system. If there, this value, this S was not present, if this S was not there, we could have told the type of system, it is a 0 type. Whereas you have one S, so it is S to the power of 1. So it is type 1. This was S square, it was type 2 system. But here it is type 1 system. The first one is type of system is type. Next, error coefficient. You have three different coefficient. First one is positional error coefficient. Positional error coefficient, as we have already seen, it is limit S tends to 0, G of S into H of S. So now, it is limit S tends to 0, G of S into H of S. H of S, it is unity feedback, so it is 1. So now, applying the limits to this, this becomes 0. Wherever we have S, make it 0. You have anything value, because this is always, you will have a 0 at the denominator, 1 by 0 is nothing but infinite. Then, the velocity error coefficient, it is limit S tends to 0, S into G of S into H of S. So, limit S tends to 0, S will cancel, you already have a S in the denominator. These two S will cancel. So now again substitute S equal to 0. Here this is 0 here. This becomes 0. This is also 0. So you are left with 1, 1 and 1. So it is equal to 20. Next, Ka is S square into limit as S tends to 0, S square, G of S into H of S. So limit S tends to 0, S square. Of this, 1 S cancels with this. You are left with S here. So anyway, because it is 0 on the top, the value will be nothing but 0. Ka will be 0. So the third part, now we have found all the error coefficient. The third part is error for a ramp input. This is a type 1 and we are giving a ramp input. So we will have a ramp, whereas the other two will not have the errors. Here, see, for ramp input, anyway, because your Kp value is infinity and Ka is 0, you only have the Kv value. For Kv, the error will be A by Kv, there is nothing but 4 by 20.2 is the error. You will have an error of 0.2 for this system. The second problem is find again the error coefficient and steady state error for a system with loop transfer function, g of s, h of s. They have already given g of s, h of s value with the input of r of t equal to 3 plus t plus t square. Okay, then now given the value, accordingly you will have to make these as 1. You have to, it should be s plus s into something plus 1. So it is 1s, that is 1 plus 0.5s. Take out 3 here, take out 2 here, you take out 3 here. Here you need not take out anything, but this is anyway 1 here. Here you have to take out 5 and here 4. Correspondingly, you get this equation, okay, when you take out these values, and this is the final expression we have. Now, apply the limits, s tends to 0. For the first one, original error, s tends to 0, v of s into h of s. So, all the s values will go to 0. So, it is nothing but 3 by 0, it is infinity. Velocity error coefficient, it is limit s tends to 0, s into g of s into h of s, 3. You have s into 3, okay, you have s into, you have a s here, see, you have a s here in the denominator, on the numerator also you have a s, so those two s will cancel each other. You see, here you have an s here, at this point you have a s, here you have a s, and in the denominator also we have a s. So these two s will cancel each other and you are left with only 3, okay, into wherever s is there you substitute 0. So it is nothing but 3. Okay? Then for acceleration error coefficient, it is s square. 1s will cancel, but you have s into the expression. When you are substituting 0 for that, obviously it becomes the entire k value becomes 0. Now, what is the error due to the input? You have calculated the error coefficient, and for the given input, what will be the error? So, the input is nothing but, we have given input is 3 plus t plus t square. The first error, the first input, if you see, a step of magnitude 3. This is r of t here means general function, a general input. It is not, they are not specifically telling that the entire thing is a ramp function. It is m of t, v of t, I of t, something like that. It is, instead of writing v of t or I of t, they have just written it as r of t. This entire thing is not a ramp function. It is just a input, just a representation for an input or r of t. How you have R of S, and see here, this one, this expression, when you write, this is input. It doesn't particularly tell that it is a ramp. This R of S, and here we have C of S. So similarly, the input here, in time domain, it is R of T. So R of T is 3 plus T plus T square. The first term is a step function. Second will be a ramp function. And the third one will be a parabolic function. The parabolic standard value will be a by 2 into t square. Okay, the standard value will be a by 2 into t square. I'll just write it as t to the power of square. So this is the actual ramp input. But here there is no, if you take the magnitude as 1, this this 2 is not there, so we'll have to divide and multiply it by 2. So this becomes a magnitude. This will be the magnitude. This t square by 2. This is the actual. It is a by 2. See, a by 2. A is nothing but this by 2 into t square. So a is value, that is the magnitude is 2 here. Then for a step input, for the first term, the step input, for a step input, you will have an error due to the positional error coefficient. So due to that, what do we have? Due to positional error coefficient, it is infinity. So magnitude is 3, 1 plus infinity is 0. For a system, when you give a step input, the error will be due to positional error. Then for a ramp input, and moreover, what kind of system this is? This is a type 1 system. For a type 1, if you see here, for a type 1 system, you will not have an error due to the step input, nor due to parabolic. You will have an error due to the ramp input. Let us verify the same here. Okay. So for step input, 0. See here in the tabular column, was it 0? Yes. And next will be the ramp function. The ramp function, the magnitude of the ramp function is here. It is 1. And what is the kV? It will have an error due to velocity error coefficient. kV is, it is a by kV, 1 by 3. What about parabolic? That is the parabolic input. The error will be a by magnitude by acceleration error coefficient. A here is 2. 2 by 0 is nothing but infinity. So the total, when you add, due to the step, due to the ramp, and due to parabolic, the 0 plus 1 by 3 plus infinity is nothing but 3 by infinity. This is the value. Coming to the third problem, for a unity feedback control system, the open loop transfer function is given here. We'll have to find positional velocity and acceleration error coefficient or constant. And steady state error when the input is t, that is r of s is here, this is in the s domain. 3 by s step function, 3 by s square, it is a ramp function, 1 by 3 s cube is a parabolic function. What will be the ramp value, the s domain value of a parabolic function? For a parabolic function, the s domain value will be, that is if I have a parabolic of, what was the value we told, a by 2 into this t to the power of 2. This is in t domain. So s domain will be what? It will be a by t to the power of 2. This will be the, it is in s domain. Laplace value will, of this will be a by t. S to the power of, it is s to the power of q. It is a by s, it is a by s to the power of 3. Power of 3. This is the Laplace value. This will be the Laplace value of the parabolic input. Parabolic input is nothing but a by 2 into t square. For that, the Laplace equivalent is a by s cube. So now, we have a will be represented here. The magnitude is 3. Here it is 2. And in this case, it is 1 by 3. Okay, next, the first thing they have asked us to find is the error coefficient. Same thing, this is what system is this? This is type 2. See, there are two poles at the origin, it is S square. Two poles at the origin, so it is S square. This will be the origin. Okay, we have two poles between at the origin here. So that is nothing but the type 2 system. Next, coming to the problem, we have to find the positional error. Positional error is nothing but limit s equal to s tending to 0 g of s into h of s. Then it is substitute that value here. We have given what is g of s and it is unit that, so h of s is 1. So 20 into 1 plus point. Again, you will have to take out 2 outside here. Okay, you will have to take out 2 outside c and get it into the standard form. After getting it into the standard form, substitute. This is 0, this is also 0, so you have 20, and this is also 0. So you have 20 by 0, anyway it is infinity. Velocity error coefficient, limit s tends to 0, s into g of s into h of s. Okay, next, it is then here you have this value is, again this will be 0, this is also 0, and this value here, this is also 0, so this becomes infinity. The second case, you have s into this value. 1s cancels with 1 of this, but still you have 1s on the denominator. So this is 0 on the denominator. So 1 by 0 will give you nothing, it is nothing but infinity. What about in this case, you have s square into g of s into h of s. So this s square and this s square will cancel. It is 20, this is 0, this is also 0, so this is nothing but 20 into 1, it is not equal to 20. Then, so now coming to the next one for the given input. The given input, the first case as we saw, it was the step input of magnitude 3. So now it is equal to 3. So this 3 by 1 plus k, p is infinity. So 1 by infinity is 0. For a ramp value, it is k by kv. Kv value is, what is kv here? Kv value was infinity. 1 by infinity is again 0. The parabolic error is k by ka. K, as I was telling you, the KF value will be 1 by 3. This is 1 by 3. So it is 1 by 3 into 20, that is 1 by 60. So the total error, you add 0 plus 0 plus 1 by 60, it is nothing but 1 by 60. Coming to the fourth problem, you have to find the positional error, velocity error, and the acceleration error coefficient for a unity feedback system with open loop transfer function. The transfer function is given and we have to find the value of k to limit the steady state error to 5 with the input 1 plus 10t plus 20t square. Again, this is in time domain. Okay, this is the standard form, a by 2 into t square. So this will be, we'll have to convert this to a by 2. Now first let us find out the error coefficient the same way, that is kp is s tends to 0, g of s into h of s. So substitute wherever you have s, because it is anyway here, you have 0, because this is 0 here, this is 0, so denominator is 0, it is infinity. Then here again the next one, velocity error coefficient is limit s tends to 0, g of s into h of s. So 1s will cancel with this, but still you have a s in the denominator, so it is again infinity, because if anything by 0 is infinity. Whereas acceleration is s square into g of s into h of s. This s square and this s square will cancel, and you have the will have the k, this is 0, this is also 0, so you will have k by 600. Then for the different inputs, what are the errors you get? First is step input, magnitude is 1 plus kp kp is nothing but infinity, 1 by infinity is 0. Second one is a ramp function of magnitude 10, 10 by kv, again 10 by infinity is 0. Third one is parabolic input, and the magnitude is 40. Okay, multiply and divide by 2, so this becomes 40. So 40 by k by 60, so it is 2400 by k. And total error here is, it is, this value is 2400. Okay, it is 2400. So next, coming to the error, that is, they have asked us to find the k value. This is the total error. Okay, this will be the total error, 0 plus 0 plus 2400 by k, so it is 2400 by k. And this error should not cross a value of 5. So less than or equal to 5, maximum is 5. So equating it to 5, we can find the k value as 480. Here again, next, fifth problem, here we'll have to find the error coefficient. Same thing, you'll have to, here these three problems are there, which try to solve it, okay? And after you solve, you will have to submit this in the mail ID. The mail ID that you need to write the test, in that you will have to submit it. You have to have the hard copy with you. Later on will be asking it for it. So write these three problems and submit it. Today is a class, you will have to submit it in another 2 days. Okay, so today is 20, so submit it on 26. Next class, we will continue with the problems again. If you have any doubt, please go through the video. If not, you can call us and ask a doubt. Go through the video.